Hi. In this video, we're going to talk about function notation. So I thought we'd start off our discussion by considering the height of a ball. So the height of a ball. Let's say somebody told you that the height of a ball is given by the following equation. H at t is equal to 3t plus 5. Okay, so these symbols look a little new to us, or they're being used in a new way. So the way we read this in mathematics is as follows. The height at a given time is equal to 3 times that time plus 5. Okay, let's write that down in English. The height, okay, now here's the important word, at. Okay, so the height at t seconds, so the height at t seconds is 3t plus 5. Okay, so it's important that you realize that whatever goes right here, that is the time that you're plugging in right there. So the height at, for example, 2 seconds would be equal to 3 times 2 plus 5. Let's write that down. So the height, for example, at 2 seconds, so the height at 2 seconds equals 3 times 2 plus 5. And that's equal to 6 plus 5, which is 11. So maybe 11 feet in this case. So the reason I emphasize that word at is so that you began thinking about knowing that this is when you want to plug in, this is the value for the time. And the way we read this is h at 2 seconds equals 3 times 2, in this case plus 5. Let's take another one. H, that is the height, at 1 second, what would that be? Well, according to my little set of instructions here, it'd be 3 times the 1 second, so 3 times 1 plus 5, which is equal to, well, 3 times 1 is 3, plus 5 is 8. So that would be 8. And then one more just to make sure we're on board. The height at 4 seconds, that would be, well, 3 times 4 plus 5, because that's what you do with the time. You multiply it by 3 and then add 5 to it. We do that every time. And 3 times 4 is 12. Plus 5, which is 17 feet, even though we usually don't write the units. Okay, so now it turns out that in these three examples I just gave you, we knew what the time was. The time was 2, the height was 11. The time was 1, the height was 8. The time was 4, the height was 17. Now we're going to practice going the other way. That is, not when somebody gives you the time and asks you to find the height, but when they give you the height and ask you to find the time. Let's go ahead and write down what that problem would look like. So, let's say, can you find the time when, okay, the height at that given time is equal to 14 feet. Okay, and once we do that, then we'll say, okay, well, maybe you can do it for 14 feet. Can you also do it, for example, for 26 feet? Okay, so there are two problems here. Can you find the time when the height is 14 feet? Can you find the time when the height is 26 feet? Okay, so, well, what's our rule for getting the height? Well, the rule is this. The height at any time is always 3 times that time added to 5. So we want to know, when is 3 times a certain time added to 5? When is that, in the first case, equal to 14? Do you see that? We took the expression that always gives us the height, 3t plus 5, and we set it equal to the height we are looking for. Now watch what happens. You can solve this equation by subtracting 5 from both sides, and you get 3t is equal to 9. Divide both sides by 3, and we get t is equal to, in this case, it's going to be 3 seconds. Okay, let's try that again for 26 feet. So can I find the time when the height is 26 feet? Well, that would be saying, well, when is 3t plus 5? That's how I always get my height. When's that equal to 26? What could that time be? I'm not sure. Well, I know how to solve this equation, so I subtract 5 from both sides. And the left-hand side is 3t equals 21. And now if I divide both sides by that 3, I find that the time in that case is 7 seconds. Okay, so that's all there is to it working with functions. Sometimes you're given the time, and sometimes you're given the height. Let's try another example just to make sure that we are understanding everything we're talking about here. So, for example, let's say you're given this, that f at x equals 2x minus 3. Okay, now you might say, wait a minute, it's not height anymore, but it's the same idea. We don't know what f necessarily represents, but you still read this the same way. F, whatever you're looking for, at x is equal to 2 times that x, take away 3. Okay, so for this function, let's say that we're asked two things. Let's say that we are first asked to A, let's say somebody said, find the function at 4, so find f at 4, so that's part A, and let's say part B was this, the value of x such that what? Such that f at that x is equal to 13. Okay, so the first problem corresponds to what we were doing at the beginning of the video, and the second part corresponds to what we were doing in the latter part. Okay, so for part A, this says find f at 4. Well, according to this, f at anything, you just take that anything and multiply it by 2 and subtract 3. So f at 4 is equal to 2 times 4, take away 3. Okay, I can do that. That's 8, take away 3, or 5. So in other words, f at 4 is equal to 5. Okay, that's our answer for the first part. And for the second part, okay, this is a little more exciting, right? Find the value of x such that f at that x is 13. But according to this, I know f at any x is 2x minus 3. So I need to find an x such that 2x minus 3 is equal to 13. Do you see the difference? The difference is here I was given the result and I was looking for the x that's going to make that true. So I want to add 3 to both sides. And I get 2x equals, well, it's going to be 16. And now I divide both sides by 2. And I get x is equal to 8. What's the meaning of this? The meaning is f at 8 is equal to 13. Let's see if that's really true. Is f at 8 really 13? If you plug an 8 in here, f at 8, it's 2 times 8, which is 16, take away 3. It's true. Okay, so in the next video, we're going to go ahead and interpret these results for functions graphically. Stay tuned.